Okay, so in the last video, we created our little custom CSS file here. So let's do something with it. First thing I'm going to do is if we go back to the site itself, let's get rid of that ugly blue. We'll get rid of that first before we do anything else. We'll get rid of that ugly blue. So if we go back to our custom CSS, we'll get rid of that and save. Back to the site, refresh. That's better, back to its white color. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and put an image behind this whole body right here. So here's my folder, and inside my folder, I'm going to create a new folder. I'm going to call it IMG, kind of short for images. You can call yours what you want, but that's pretty standard for images or whatever you want to call it. Now inside here, I'm going to find an image quickly and put it in there. There we go. Now I've put an image in there. Let's get it so you can see it. It's just a JPEG image that I created in Photoshop. And it's, if we click on it, find the dimensions of it. It's 1,000 pixels by 667 high. So it's width, then height. So it's fairly large. I mean, because it's going to cover, I could have had a bigger one. 1920 really would have been ideal. This will do for our purposes. And I'm going to set this as the background image. And the name of this file is B1. Background 1. Call yours whatever you like. And if we hit the properties again, you can see that it is a JPEG. JPEG. JPG. So we've got to have .jpg after it when we're referring to this image. So now let's go back to our custom CSS. And the body is where I'm going to put this image. If we look, there's the body. And the body is everything that's inside this thing. Everything. So I'm going to put this image behind that body right there so it'll cover the whole thing. So in our custom CSS, just like when I added the background just now, I'm going to say background. Colon. Then I'm going to write URL because it's got to find that image and it's straight in the same folder as our index, so I don't have to put anything else in there. As soon as I've opened those round brackets, it's found that image folder. So if I click on the image folder, or you can type this in, as soon as I click that, it's found the B1 JPEG. And if you put your cursor over it, it'll show you what you've just found there. Okay, so we want to put a semicolon after that. We always want to put a semicolon after our little bits of CSS code here. You can get away with not doing it on the last one, but it's a good idea to do it. That way, if you add any, it'll read it. If you forget your semicolon, it will not read whatever's below it. Now, background size. I want this to cover the whole thing. So I'm going to write cover. Well, it's prompted us there. Thank you, brackets. And what do we want to do next? Put a semicolon after it. There we go. Let's save that. Control S. And go back to our site. Refresh. There we have it. We've got that background image behind our site here. Now it looks a blurry mess. That's okay, because we're going to style everything. So that's great. We've put our background image in. In the next video, I'm going to move this nav bar down to the bottom.